Hey, it's Celebrate Truth. I'm Robbie Davidson. I'm just curious what subject you can teach if you only know 4%. Well, I guess you could teach the universe. That's right, the universe. In science classes everywhere, they constantly are teaching the Big Bang, heliocentric, space continuum, and it's fascinating and everyone loves it. But really, they even admit they only know 4%. Can you just imagine having a doctor perform anything on you that only knows 4%. Nowhere in society do we allow anyone to teach any subject matter when they only know 4%. They have absolutely no clue. We see this time and time again. New article MSN just released gets into talking about the fact that they're still trying to figure out missing pieces. Kind of like the missing pieces of evolution. They've been looking for so many years for that missing link. Those transitional fossils over millions of years, we would see like hundreds of thousands of transitional fossils. And yet, how many have they found? Oh, that's right, zero. Uh-oh, doesn't work with your paradigm, but yep, you keep on teaching it. If you don't answer correctly, you fail. Well, you know what the greatest fail that I've seen in a long time? Knowing 4% of subject matter and teaching it as the truth. Here we go again with this article, and it starts off, "It would be silly to think we completely understand our universe, given how small the Earth is compared to the vastness of the cosmos. But here, on our tiny planet, it appears that much of the universe is missing. And I'm not just talking about dark matter. Regular stuff seems to be missing too. Dun, dun, dun." Astronomy fans, as we'll call them, astronomy fanboys, because there are so many people that love space. I mean, I don't know if you caught my last video with Trump's Space Force announcement, but again, people in the background, the entire stadium, or I don't even know, Coliseum, or whatever they were in, they're all chanting, "Space Force, Space Force." I mean, they're excited. People love space.
"And I think you saw the other day, we're reopening NASA. We're going to be going to space. Space Force."
Here comes the chatting. People love space.
"Space Force."
And yet, as we read and as we learn, they only know 4%.
4%.
So anyways, astronomy fans probably know that as far as humans can tell, the universe is comprised mostly of some mysterious, unexplained energy called dark energy. They have no freaking clue what dark energy or dark matter is, for that matter. Another unexplained thing that seems to build the universe's skeleton. Just 4% is the regular matter that we can see. Stars, planets, interstellar, and intergalactic gas. But the observed amount of this regular matter still falls perhaps a third short of the amount of stuff that physicists think should exist based on their model of the universe. Now, there's a lot in that sentence. Now, there's all the stuff we should be seeing based on our model. Guys, your model is completely wrong. It's a lie, and yet you teach it as fact. You only know 4%.
4%.
Now, I'm going to put the link in the description. You can check this out. It continues on saying they're looking for all this stuff, and this guy, this scientist, this group of scientists thought they found something, and no. Oh, we think we detected something, but yeah, no, it's not working. The model is not working. The model is a lie, and yet only knowing 4%, you're still allowed to teach this in classrooms. What other industry are you allowed to teach anything when you only know 4%? Can you imagine a mechanic? You know, hey, my car broke down. I'm going to take it to the mechanic that only knows 4% of how to fix a car. No, you go to someone that is basically credited, that's actually studied, that knows 100%, if not maybe a little bit less. But really, come on, if you get 4% in class, you fail.
4%.
These guys, this is a master, absolute disaster. Fail when it comes to the Big Bang heliocentric universe that their model, they've been pushing their agenda for so long, and yet interesting that actually scientists are coming forward saying we really don't have a clue. I mean, remember this famous quote from Michio Kaku? Usually in science, if we're off by a factor of 2 or a factor of 10, we call that horrible. We say something's wrong with the theory or the model. We're off by a factor of 10. However, in cosmology, we're off by a factor of 10 to the 120. That is one with 120 zeros after it. This is the largest mismatch between theory and experiment in the history of science. So you have accredited scientist himself saying that we have freaking no clue what's going on. And yet it angers me to no end when they continue to teach this. And they'll say, you're a moron, you're an idiot if you believe anything else. I mean, we already know NASA, and look at the pictures. And oh, look at, there was a car that SpaceX, they just put up a car. Hello, we know. And it's like, pictures are not scientific. Videos is not empirical data. Hello, let's get back to real true science. And let's get back to the fact of basically stating that you need to know more than 4%. I mean, if they knew 51%, we could get it as maybe a theory, a teachable theory. But what I find is interesting, and I know that a few states, maybe not still, anyone in the comments can let me know if you know of any states that teach both in the classrooms as far as creation and evolution as two proposed theories on the origins of everything. I think that there were a few states, maybe they've all been repealed, but for a while, that was the kind of the war that was going on. I think the next war needs to be on cosmology, because I think that they would claim they know more about evolution than they know about cosmology. They would say, we know 80 or 90% about evolution. We're missing some links, we're missing 10% or 20%. But think about this, they only know 4%.
4%.
They admit this, they have quoted this. We need to focus on this because I think it is incredibly important. 4%, are you kidding me?
4%.
A doctor that know 4% would fail, they wouldn't be a doctor.
4%.
A mechanic that got 4% on his test, he would fail, he 4%. Wouldn't be a mechanic. In any industry, nobody would be teaching children, would be teaching generations a lie, a model that doesn't even hold anything, not even close to 51%. 4%. I mean, they haven't got even to 5%. Just 4% is the regular matter that they can see as far as the stars and the planets and the stuff that is tangible. Everything else they're making up as they go along. Dark matter, dark energy, blah, 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 black holes, and oh, gravity waves, and all this nonsense that they see like 2.3, you know, billion years ago, or, you know, a light year away is 7 trillion miles. I mean, what kind of lens can you see a trillion miles away? I mean, I've got some pretty good camera equipment. There's some pretty interesting lenses out there, but come on, a trillion miles? Do the math on that.
Switches in auto. 3, 2, 1, release. I'm backing away.
I see, you got it open. Clear the pin.
Clear the pin. Mode switches in off.
Do you have a H dot?
Yeah, it's about 65 of the ref bar.
But they're seeing stuff that's 100 trillion miles away. 200, 300, 400 trillion miles away. This is just nonsense. This is absolute propaganda. People are buying into it. They're saying, well, NASA saw it. The Hubble telescope must have seen something. And oh, those astronauts, they're such nice guys. They would never lie to us. Even though they're branches of the military. You got Trump himself talking about being branches of the military. This is government. This is highly classified. There's oaths put in place for the betterment of the world, of society. And again, this is all one big lie. But again, 4% is what they know, and they teach us this fact. So the next war, I think, needs to be on cosmology. I think that we need to have other theories taught. Absolutely, is a matter of fact when you're basically stating you only know 4% of your
4%.
Modern day theories and your models. They're obviously not even close to being true. And yet they're still continuing on to push this. What does that tell you? That tells you that there's an agenda. That tells you that the education system is rigged. That tells you that no matter what happens, they're going to keep pushing forward with their evolutionary, Big Bang, heliocentric cosmology. Again, it's a war on God. And if you can't see this, you need to wake up. You need to understand that there are two massive powers in place. Understand that God's created order, God's truth, told us precisely exactly how this world was created, the origins, who we are, where we are, all these things. It completely explains it. Yet modern day science, atheism, the world's basically philosophies and ideologies are in direct opposition to God. This is a war against truth. It is against a war. It's a war against the word of God. When it comes to the creation, when it comes to the foundations, understand when you take out the foundations of anything, it falls apart. This is an attack on Genesis, on the created order, on God's word. Now, you might not be religious. You might be listening to this and think it's all crazy, but understand that they're teaching you something they only know 4% of.
4%.
And yet we're the crazy ones. Guys, let's keep exposing the lies and celebrate the truth. Until next time, I'll have a video real quick. And I hope you have a great day. Blessings.